This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The former Court of Appeals in Cases of Capture, established by resolution of the Congress of the Confederation on January 15, 1780, was the first federal court in the United States of America. Contents 1. Origin 2. Authority for establishment 3. Duration 4. Jurisdiction 5. Times and locations of sessions 6. Procedure 7. Judges Chapter 8. Cases 9. See also 10. Endnotes 11. Sources 12. Further reading. Origin. During the American Revolution, the United States issued letters of marque in reprisal, authorizing private vessels, known as privateers, to capture enemy ships and cargo as prizes. The idea for the court originated from requests sent by General George Washington during the American Revolution to President of Congress John Hancock, but initially resulted in only the establishment of committees within Congress to exercise such jurisdiction. Upon learning of this deviation from his earlier requests, Washington sent another request to Hancock, again asking that Congress establish the court, but Congress did not fulfill his request until almost 4 years later. Authority for establishment. Although specific express power to establish the court was granted to Congress in the Articles of Confederation, the Articles of Confederation were not yet fully ratified by all 13 of the original states when Congress established the court on January 15, 1780. However, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that Congress nonetheless had inherent power at that time to establish the court. Duration. The court operated from shortly after its founding in 1780 through its final cases in 1787. It officially ceased to exist following ratification of the U.S. Constitution in 1789 that transferred federal judicial power to the newly created U.S. Supreme Court and such other inferior, i.e., lower federal courts as Congress may establish. Jurisdiction. Beginning with Massachusetts on November 1, 1775, several of the American colonies and, later, states established prize courts to exercise original jurisdiction over all cases or libels of captures or prizes consisting of enemy ships and cargo. Establishment of such courts was recommended by Congress on November 25, 1775. On November 25, 1775, Congress also asserted federal appellate jurisdiction over such cases following repeated scheduling difficulties. When Congress attempted to hear the first appeal, Congress initially assigned this jurisdiction to various special committees, followed by a standing committee on January 30, 1777. Later, on January 15, 1780, Congress established the Court of Appeals in Cases of Capture to exercise this jurisdiction as a court of last resort. On May 24, 1780, Congress transferred all remaining appeals pending before committees to the court and specified that all future appeals were to be filed directly with the court. On June 27, 1786, the court's jurisdiction was again expanded to include re-hearings and new trials in certain cases wherever justice so required. Special jurisdiction was also conferred upon the court on February 11, 1782 for a capture adjudicated by a prize court in Connecticut, and on July 24, 1786 for a capture of the sloop Chester. Times and locations of sessions. The first session of the court was required to be held in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania at the earliest opportunity. Subsequent sessions were to be held at other times and locations in the United States as deemed conducive to the public good, but no farther east than Hartford, Connecticut, and no farther south than Williamsburg, Virginia. Congress later specified the time and location for some sessions of the court, including specific sessions to be held at Hartford, Connecticut, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Richmond, Virginia, and New York. New York. Procedure. The primary means of initiating an appeal to the court required a party to first demand an appeal in the trial court within 5 days after definitive sentence, and then file an appeal in and give adequate security to the court within 40 days after demanding an appeal in the trial court. On September 5, 1781, an extension of time for appeal was granted in the case of a capture decided in favor of Patrick Mahon against Roger Keene. Additionally, some appeals filed with Congress and referred to committees were subsequently transferred to the court. Trial by jury was considered inconsistent with the usage of nations, and, therefore, was not authorized in the court. However, trial by jury was authorized in some of the state prize courts, where Congress initially recommended it, only to later recommend against it in any case before the court that involved a capture suspected of being collusive. The court was required to demand sufficient proof to the contrary from the captor, and, if the captor failed to meet this burden, the court was required to award the prize to the state where the original trial was held. Judges. The court was composed of 3 judges, but a quorum only required the presence of 2 judges. All judges serving serving on the court were first required to take the following oath of office administered before the President of Congress. You do swear or affirm that you will well, faithfully and impartially execute the office of one of the judges of the Court of Appeals in cases of capture, according to the best of your skill and judgment, so help you God. Initially, the judges received annual salaries for their services with reimbursement for expenses, but their compensation was later changed to provide for only fixed daily rates, including time spent traveling on official business of the court. The following individuals were elected by Congress to serve as judges on the court: William Paca, elected January 22, 1780, accepted February 8, 1780, resigned November 21, 1782. Titus Hosmer, elected January 22, 1780, accepted April 12, 1780, died in office August 4, 1780. George Wythe, elected January 22, 1780, declined to serve February 21, 1780. Cyrus Griffin, elected April 28, 1780, accepted May 4, 1780. George Read, elected December 5, 1782, accepted December 10, 1782. John Lowell, elected December 5, 1782, accepted February 12, 1783 as judges on the court. George Read had seniority over John Lowell based on the results of an election in Congress held on December 13, 1782. Cases surviving records show that a total of 56 cases were lodged with and adjudicated or otherwise disposed of by the court, including 11 cases that were transferred from committees within Congress to the court. Although the court did not generally issue formal written opinions of its decisions, opinions of the court were nonetheless published in the following cases: the Resolution, 2 U.S. 2 Dal 1, Court App in Cases of Capture 1781. The Resolution, 2 U.S. 2 Dal 19, Court App in Cases of Capture 1781 Rehearing the Erstern, 2 U.S. 2 Dal 34, Court App in Cases of Capture 1782 The Gloucester, 2 U.S. 2 Dal 36, Court App in Cases of Capture 1782 The Squirrel, 2 Dal 40 Court App in Cases of Capture 1783 Authorized Sale of Ship to Avoid Deterioration, Proceeds from Sale Remain Subject to Adjudication Using Star Pagination from 1st Ed the Speedwell, 2 Dal 40 Court App in Cases of Capture 1784 Reversed Condemnation because capture occurred after preliminary articles of peace using star pagination from 1st ed. Luke v. Hulbert, 2 Dal 41 Court App in Cases of Capture 1787 Dismissed using star pagination from 1st ed. The Experiment v. The Chester, 2 Dal 41 Court App in Cases of Capture 1787 Dismissed using star pagination from 1st ed. Custody of records from the court was first transferred to the U.S. Supreme Court. However, the National Archives now maintains custody of the records. See also Federal Judiciary of the United States Prize Court Prize Law. Letter of Mark Privateer Second Continental Congress American Revolutionary War Endnotes Carat A. B. Contal Cong, Journal and Records from January 15, 1780, in 16 Journals 61-64 Carat George Washington, Letter to the President of Congress dated November 11, 1775, in 3 The Writings 213-14 Carat George Washington, Letter to the President of Congress dated December 4, 1775, in 3 The Writings 257-58 Carat Contal Cong, Journal and Records from November 17, 1775, in 3 Journals 357-58 Carat Contal Cong, Journal and Records from November 23, 1775, in 3 Journals 364-65 Carat Contal Cong, Journal and Records from November 24, 1775, in 3 Journals 368-69 Carat ABCD Contal Cong. Journal and Records from November 25, 1775, in 3 Journals 371-75 Carat George Washington, Letter to the President of Congress dated December 14, 1775, in 3 The Writings 274 Carat Contal Cong, Journal and Records from December 26, 1775, in 3 Journals 457 Carat Articles of Confederation Artix, Section 1 Carat Maryland did not ratify until February 2, 1781. See Discussion of Ratification by the States in Articles of Confederation Carat Penhallow v. Dones Admirs, 3 U.S. 54 Passam 1795 Holding throughout a seriatim opinion that Congress had inherent power to establish the Court of Appeals in cases of capture prior to ratification of the Articles of Confederation Carat J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, 131 U.S. App at XXVIII, XXIX, and XXXVXLIX See Cases verses numbered 21, 38, 40, 45, 49, 50, 53, 56, 65 through 68, and 72 adjudicated or otherwise disposed of in 1780. J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, 131 U.S. App at XXVIII, XXIX, and XXXVXLIX. See cases numbered 87, 89, 103, and 109 adjudicated or otherwise disposed of in 1787. See discussion of ratification by the states in United States. Constitution U.S. Const. Art. 3, Section 1, see also discussion of Section 1 in Article 3 of the United States Constitution. Penhallow v. Doane's Admirers, 3 U.S. 54 1795, 86 Opinion of Patterson, J. The existence of the Court of Appeals terminated with the old government. J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, in 131 U.S. App at XXXXII. Contal Kong, Journal and Records from August 5, 1776. In 5 Journals 631. Contal Kong, Journal and Records from August 12, 1776, in 5 Journals 647. Contal Kong, Journal and Records from August 26, 1776, in 5 Journals 702. Contal Kong, Journal and Records from September 9, 1776, in 5 Journals 747. Contal Kong, Journal and Records from September 30, 1776, in 5 Journals 835. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from October 17, 1776, in 6 Journals 884-85. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from November 7, 1776, in 6 Journals 931-32. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from November 27, 1776, in 6 Journals 985-86. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from December 31, 1776, in 6 Journals 1060. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from January 4, 1777, in 7 Journals 13. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from January 11, 1777, in 7 Journals 30. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from January 30, 1777, in 7 Journals 75. Carat J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, in 131 U.S. App at XXIII, XXV, and XXXVXLIX. See cases numbered 1 through 64. ABCDEF Contal Kong, Journal and Records from January 15, 1780, in 16 Journals 61. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from May 24, 1780, in 17 Journals 457-59. Carat A.B. Contal Kong, Journal and Records from June 27, 1786, in 30 Journals 355-56. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from February 11, 1782, in 22 Journals 72. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from July 24, 1786, in 30 Journals 423-24. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from January 29, 1783, in 24 Journals 98. Carat A.B. Contal Kong, Journal and Records from May 24, 1780, in 17 Journals 459. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from September 5, 1781, in 21 Journals 935-36. Carat J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, in 131 U.S. App at XXXIVXLI. See cases numbered 3, 18, 21, 30, 38, 40, 45, 49, 50, 53, and 56. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from January 15, 1780, in 16 Journals 62. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from July 17, 1782, in 22 Journals 392-93. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from May 24, 1780, in 17 Journals 458. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from September 13, 1780, in 18 Journals at 822. Carat Contal Kong, Journal and Records from July 1, 1785, in 29 Journals 493. Carat Contal Kong, Journal Journal and Records from February 9, 1786, in 30 Journals 60-61, Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from May 19, 1786, in 30 Journals 291, ABC Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from January 22, 1780, in 16 Journals 79, Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from February 9, 1780, in 16 Journals 143, Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from November 21, 1782, in 23 Journals 746. AB Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from May 4, 1780, in 16 Journals 411 J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, in 131 U.S. App at XXVI Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from March 13, 1780, in 16 Journals 254 Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from April 28, 1780, in 16 Journals 397 AB Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from December 5, 1782, in 23 Journals 765 Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from December 19, 1782, in 23 Journals 821 Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from March 17, 1783, in 24 Journals 186 Kontal Kong, Journal and Records from December 13, 1782, in 23 Journals 797 J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, in 131 U.S. App at XXXIVXLIXC Cases numbered 3, 18, 21, 30, 38, 40, 45, 49, 50, 53, 56, and 65-109 J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts, in 131 U.S. App at XXXV. 2-1-41 Using Star Pagination from 1st ed. Act of May 8, 1792, ch. 36, section 12, 1 stat 275, 279 Transferring custody of records from the Court of Appeals in cases of capture to the U.S. Supreme Court Act of June 19, 1934, pub. L. No. 73-432, 48 stat 1122 Establishing the National Archives Revolutionary War Prize Cases of available at the National Archives as microform publication M162 Sources J.C. Bancroft Davis, Federal Courts prior to the adoption of the Constitution, in 131 U.S. App at XIXLXIII New York and Albany, Banks. 1776-1787 Available at the National Archives as microform publication M162VE Government of the United States under the Articles of Confederation Congresses First Continental Congress Second Continental Congress The U.S. in Congress Assembled Delegates Committee of the States Congressional Officers President Secretary Civil Offices Officers Postmaster General Superintendent of Finance Agent of the Marine Secretary at War Secretary of Foreign Affairs Court of Appeals Military Board of War Continental Army Commander-in-Chief Continental Navy Continental Marines V.E. George Washington First President of the United States, 1789-1797 Senior Officer of the Army, 1798-1799 Commander-in-Chief of the Continental Army, 1775-1783 Second Continental Congress, 1775 First Continental Congress, 1774 Military Career Revolutionary War Military Career. French and Indian War Jumonville Glen Battle of Fort Necessity Forbes Expedition Washington and the American Revolution Commander-in-Chief Continental Army Boston Campaign Siege of Boston New York and New Jersey Campaign Delaware River Crossing Battle of Trenton Philadelphia Campaign Valley Forge Battles of Saratoga Yorktown Campaign Siege of Yorktown Culper Spy Ring Newburgh Conspiracy Newburgh Letter Established, Badge of Military Merit Purple Heart Aides-de-Camp Commander-in-Chief's Headquarters Morristown and Ford Mansion Horses, Nelson and Blueskin Other U.S. Founding Events 1769 Virginia Association Continental Association 1774 Fairfax Resolves Court of Appeals in Cases of Capture 1785 Mount Vernon Conference Chairman, 1787 Constitutional Convention Presidency United States Presidential Election, 1788-89 1792. First Inauguration Inaugural Bible Second Inauguration Title of Mr. President Cabinet of the United States Secretary of State Attorney General Secretary of the Treasury Secretary of War Judiciary Act of 1789 Non-Intercourse Act Whiskey Rebellion Militia Acts of 1792 Coinage Act of 1792 United States Mint Proclamation of Neutrality Neutrality Act of 1794 Jay Treaty Pinckney's Treaty Slave Trade Act of 1794 Residence Act Thanksgiving Proclamation Farewell Address State of the Union Address 1790-1791-1792-1793-1796 Cabinet Federal Judicial Appointments Views and Public Image Presidential Library The Washington Papers Religious Views Washington and Slavery Town Destroyer Legacy Life and Homes Early Life Birthplace Ferry Farm Boyhood Home Mount Vernon Gristmill Woodlawn Plantation Samuel Osgood House, First Presidential Mansion Alexander Macomb House, Second Presidential Mansion President's House, Philadelphia Germantown White House Custis Estate Potomac Company James River and Kanawha Canal Mountain Road Lottery Congressional Gold Medal Thanks of Congress President General, Society of the Cincinnati Washington College Washington and Lee University Electoral History of George Washington Memorials and Depictions Washington D.C. Washington State Washington Monument Mount Rushmore Washington's Birthday Purple Heart The Apotheosis of Washington George Washington Houdin George Washington Sirachi Washington Crossing the Delaware Unfinished Portrait Lansdowne Portrait The Washington Family Portrait Washington at Princeton Painting George Washington University Washington University Washington Masonic National Memorial George Washington Memorial Parkway George Washington Bridge Washington and Jefferson National Forests Washington Monument, Baltimore Washington D.C. Statue List of Monuments List of Places U.S. Postage Stamps Washington Franklin Issues 1932 Bicentennial Currency Washington Quarter Washington Dollar Cultural Depictions George Washington 1984 Miniseries 1986 Sequel Related Bibliography Founding Fathers of the United States Republicanism Federalist Party Federalist Era Virginia Dynasty Coat of Arms Cherry Tree Anecdote River Farm Washington's Crossing 1751 Barbados Trip Category SYNG Inkstand General of the Armies American Philosophical Society American Revolution Patriots Mount Vernon Ladies Association Ancestry and Family Martha Washington Wife John Park Custis Stepson George Washington Park Custis Step Grandson, Adopted Son Eleanor Park Custis Step Granddaughter, Adopted Daughter Augustine Washington Father Mary Ball Mother Lawrence Washington Half-Brother Augustine Washington Jr. Half-Brother Betty Washington Lewis Sister Samuel Washington Brother John A. Washington Brother Charles Washington Brother Lawrence Washington Grandfather John Washington Great-Grandfather Bushrod Washington Nephew John Adams Category